So with two down and two left to go, let's go ahead and do it. Bang. I'm going to definitely need some hyper potions here. Super potions, got plenty of those as well. More than enough to go around. Next, Legs is going to lead us into this room. Another familiar face, or rear end, rather. There we go, a familiar face. Welcome to the Rock Chamber. Alright, it's the kahuna of Akala Island, Olivia. No introduction needed here. Time to battle me. Well said. Ooh, serious face. Time to fight Olivia again. Loving it. Five Pokemon, you know the drill. Relicanth starts things off. Rock water type, or actually it's a water rock type. Who knew? It doesn't matter, it's the same two types, but I like to be accurate. Its moves are Hydro Pump, Ancient Power, and Yawn. Yup. According to my source, it's only got three moves. Olivia, you're kind of an idiot. Anyway, double weak to grass type moves. If you've got a grass type, then Relicanth is toast. Golem. Or Golem, however you want to pronounce that. You know what? I don't really have anything else that'd be good against a rock and electric type, so let's keep Legs going here. Golem's moves are Thunder Punch, Rock Blast, and Steam Roller. Again, only three moves. What is with you, Olivia? I thought you were smarter than this. Attack down. Loving it. Oh, going for Steam Roller. That is a pretty cool animation. It does have a chance of flinching. But, because I'm faster, it does not have any flinching capacity. I don't want Antidote, I want Awakening. I've only got one, but it's worth it. Another Steamroller. I'm confident in Legs' ability to take another one. Another Trop Kick will lower his attack even further. And then one more should take care of it, unless she heals. She healed. RIP. I think it could get off one more steamroller before I have to heal. All those attack debuffs, though. Don't worry, legs. Hang tough. And down it goes. We almost ran out of Trop Kicks there. We've only got 5 or 6 left. But... oh well. We've got elixirs. Courtesy of Lily and Gladion. Ooh, everyone's just leveling up today. In this battle, that is. Lycanroc. Bringing out the big guns, I see. How about we go with... Edgelord. Just because of that disguise. I don't want to risk Smidvarg just yet. So Lycanroc is still her main. It is a pure rock type. Its moves are Crunch, Stone Edge, Counter, and Rock Climb. It has the Rockium Z. I'm going to spend this time going for Hone Claws. So it didn't go for the Z move. Does the AI take disguise into account? I wonder. Okay, that did not do as much damage as I had hoped. Alrighty then. Let's go with another play rough. I'm beating this dog senseless. And I keep avoiding Stone Edge. I love to see that. Shadow Claw to finish things off. Pokémon Refresh is overpowered. Case in point, it just got a critical hit. Edgelord, you little beast. Carbink, really? We have to put up with Carbink? Ah, great. Smidvarg, get in here. Don't want to have to put up with this... with this Carbink BS. Well, unlike the last time we fought a Carbink, we actually have some super effective moves at our disposal. It is a Rock Fairy type with the moves Power Gem, Moonblast, and Reflect. So we're right back to the three-move thing. Because it has Reflect, we're going for Hydro Pump. I was right on the money there. Oh! Not even Carbink, a defensive tank, could take that hit. Smidvarg, you truly are amazing. Probopass is her last Pokemon. I don't really have anything that can go with go for a Rock and Steel type. So I think Plague, we'll go for that. Good old Plague. Probopass, level 54, Rock Steel type. Moves are Earth Power, Power Gem, Thunder Wave, and Sandstorm. So, a little bit worried, but not too much worried. Probably has Sturdy, so I'm going to use Flamethrower right quick. Going to singe his nose hairs. He's going to paralyze me. Congratulations. You just paralyzed me. Maybe another Flamethrower. This was probably a really bad decision. Another Flamethrower. Sandstorm is going to be very annoying. Take that pelvic thrust. Plague buffeted by Sandstorm. Loving it. You know what? We will give you a full restore. I've only got 3 of them. so I have to use them sparingly. Power gem again. Buffeted by sandstorm again. Reflect wore off. That gives me free reign with flare blitz. Can you take the heat? He even did a critical hit. Plague. You remarkable monstrosity. Never cease to amaze me. Olivia gave us a bit of a hard time, no pun intended whatsoever. That might also be seen as a double entendre, considering whether or not your mind is in the gutter or not. I don't see the same look in your eyes that I saw when we first met on Akala Island. Have you had some experiences that you'll carry with you in your heart forever? Well, it's time for you to move on. Alrighty then. Last but not least, the fourth Elite Four member, we better heal up first before we go and take him on. Hyper potions. Legs, you'll want one. And Soul Plague. And I think... who will I go for? Edgelord, how about you? You're pretty awesome, aren't you? Here we go. The final chamber is against none other than a familiar yellow jacket-wearing guy. Someone we know very well. Old Hala is here to make you holler. Oh yeah. That battle cry is worth hollering about. And that... The arms flex to bring about the barrier around the battle platform. That is amazing. Your old kahuna is now also a member of the Elite Four. Well, this time I'm holding nothing back. Time for you to see what I can really do. Oh yes, another battle with Hala. See, Hala is a big part of the reason why I really can't decide on a least favorite member for this Elite Four. I love them all to bits. I mean, Hala's a badass, Acerola is adorable, Olivia's gorgeous, and Kahili uses flying types. So they're all, like, equally awesome in my opinion. Anyway, we got Hariyama coming out. Fake out, close combat, knockoff. Only three attacks. Kinda stupid if you ask me. Level 54, pure fighting type, you know the drill. Let's hone claws. And you didn't start with fake out, I'm surprised. Knock off, what'd you do? What item do I have? Expert belt, right. Oh, that's right! Normal and fighting type moves have no effect on Edgelord, so he's restricted to that attack. He's restricted to knock off. I'm just gonna use a couple more hone claws. So I can knock him out with one play rough. Hala, are you serious? You can't do anything to my Mimikyu if you stick to fighting and normal moves. Well, I'm gonna play rough with you. Nice knowing you, chump. And he was even a critical hit. With three Hone Claws buffs, it's tempting to just sweep the rest of his team with my Edgelord, but I can't. I've got to save up those play roughs. Okay, so Crabominable is coming out next. Fantastic. He's it's his main Pokemon, the evolved form of Crabrawler. But it's a fighting and ice type, so come on. You know I'm going for the cat wrestler. For some reason, I just really like Crabominable's cry. It sounds weirdly appealing to me. And his design is weirdly appealing. I just like the concept of a crab and a yeti, a literal yeti crab. Very creative on Game Freak's part. It's a real animal, but they went all out with the design. It's only two moves, according to my sources, are Ice Hammer and Close Combat. It is the Phytinium Z. So I better hope I one-shot knock out this thing, because otherwise Plague is not surviving. There we go. Crabominable is just a disappointing Pokemon. It is incredibly powerful, but it just doesn't have the defenses and it doesn't have the speed. And it has a lot of weaknesses, being a fighting and ice type. Don't get me wrong, fighting and ice is a fantastic offensive combo. But it's just not a good defensive combo, and really, I think they could have added a bit more to Crabominable's defenses in order to compensate for that. So, alright. Who are we going to send out up against the Prime Ape? Nuru. Nuru hasn't had much time to shine. Primeape, pure fighting type. Its moves are Cross Chop, Outrage, Punishment, and Pursuit. So four moves. I guess Hala decided he'd be smart with Primeape, but not with the others for some reason. Cross Chop is not going to do a lot. Both Bug and Fairy resist fighting. For its other moves, Punishment and Pursuit will not do a whole lot, and Outrage does nothing at all to Fairy types. One more Psychic will take care of it. It's super effective, indeed. Poliwrath. Looks like it's another job for the legs. She doesn't have a lot of Trop Kicks left on her. But I think we can still make this work. Actually, let's go with Acrobatics. We haven't been using Acrobatics a lot. And it's just a wicked strong move. Poliwrath is a water and fighting type. Water and fighting type, pardon me. Its only moves are Waterfalled Submission. So it's kind of stupid, but okay. Turns out we could finish the fight just fine with Acrobatics. No Trop Kicks needed. And finally, Beware. Good old Beware. I've gained some massive respect for this Pokemon ever since I decided to use Can't Bear It temporarily. Plus, he's hilarious in the anime. Or would that be Bewarely? I'm not even gonna make that joke. Normal fighting type. Its only moves are Hammer Arm and Brutal Swing. So, all right. Sure. Let's go with that. It most likely has the fluffy ability, so fire types are good against this thing. And with one final move, the Elite Four have been conquered. I could feel the power you gained on your journey through Ula'ula. It is only when the balance of the old and the new is just right that you can create something truly original. That is what I saw in the battle between us, an elder's experience and the fire of youth. Unfortunately, I am currently out of recording time. We're going to have to leave the champion and the fantastic ending to this game until the next recording session. So that will be it. We'll leave it off here, and then I'll do the champ. Not the champion, the final boss. Final boss, the credits, the entire beautiful ending of this game, I assure you, it is fantastic. And then we'll go straight to the after game. So, this has been Cottonmouth 255, the Spore Serpent. Farewell and many great goodbyes, and I shall see you again soon for the epic conclusion of Pokémon Moon. See you later, have a good day, and get hyped, guys. The ending is right around the corner.